Now, life is not always kind to professional footballers after their playing careers are over. The Booth Foundation is one of those who are trying to help wherever they can. And when the co-founders of this foundation heard about the Patrick Mbuthu's flight and loss of vision, they rolled up their sleeves to give a helping hand. Now, to talk about this, I'm joined in studio by former Bafana Bafana player and defender Mathew Booth. Mathew, good morning to you. Thank you for joining us this morning.
Good morning. Good to be here.
So speak to us about the work that you guys are doing out at the foundation, because we know as media and often we hear about footballers' careers and how life after football is looking for them. So what is it that you are trying to do with former players?
Yeah, well, first of all, the stats are a little bit worrying.
More than worrying.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Both in Europe and in South Africa, you know, 75% of footballers 5 years after retirement are going to be divorced, bankrupt, or drug or alcohol dependent, or a mixture of those. So that's in Europe and in South Africa. It's also not an unusual phenomenon. You know, the NFL, NBA also suffer similar stats. And I think in South Africa, we could actually include the entertainment industry as a whole. We often hear of, you know, our idols, legends passing away without much savings in the bank. And it's not a good way to go. And Booth Africa is basically attempting to give footballers in particular a soft landing and a smooth transition into what I call the afterlife, which is retirement.
And how do you guys do that? Talk me through the process of how you look to give them the soft landing.
Yeah, we offer basically infrastructure builds, sports events and football clinics. So the sports events and football clinics are really where we want to try and incorporate our ex-legends, ex-players, get them inducted back into the industry. You often find that players who have played 15, 20 years in the Premiership or overseas, once they retire, they're not brought back into the industry and they've got all that experience sitting at home, struggling to find things to do. And we're trying to incorporate them back into the industry to give back to basically communities that have given us so much.
I love hearing that. But when we speak about the work that you do, surely from a financial point of view, it's not easy. So speak to me about your funding and your funding challenges. How are you getting your financing? Where is it coming from? You don't have to give me all the nitty-gritty, but sure. Just from a financial point of view, do you have that backing?
Yeah, so initially a lot of it was basically out of our own pockets. My partner, Bongani Ntombeni, she's got incredible business acumen, so she certainly helped me, because when I retired, I didn't know how to write up a proposal or to, you know, fill out an Excel spreadsheet.
Exactly. Defendable. Exactly.
So it's important for players to establish mentors and business people who are captains of industry while they are still playing, because you're a high profile when you're playing, but as soon as you retire, that falls away. It's like driving a new car out of the dealership. You know, you lose that value immediately. Mm-hmm. So players, I would like to encourage them to establish a good, healthy network while they're still playing, and basically, we look at corporates to support us. You know, we are intent on rolling out football clinics at schools in particular. We feel that schools football has really lost its impetus and momentum since around about 2013. And those are important hubs, especially outside of our metros. There's many communities and schools that are crying out for interaction and giving the opportunities for both boys and girls to shine, and including the legends while we're at it. So it's you're killing two or three birds with one stone, so to speak.
And you speak about your own journey and your own path as a footballer, how you didn't know how to write up a proposal, all you knew to do was play football. Speak to me about your desire then to assist a Patrick Mbuthu when you heard about the challenges that he was going through and how you guys have assisted him.
Yeah, so we've helped to organize two very successful events in Gaborone and Botswana over the last 2 years. It's called Clash of Legends. Our partners in Botswana came up with this brainchild. And it's basically a Legends game, which included a football clinic over a weekend. This last occasion, in the inaugural event, we had 15,000 spectators who paid to come and watch us, a generation that had finished playing professional football almost 10 years ago. So there's a demand for the Legends to be seen and for us to be playing still. And this year as well, we had the likes of Sipiri Shabalala, Teko Madise involved, and of course the crowd was out there again supporting. And we've helped 7 beneficiaries in total. So ex-sports people who have either suffered strokes or been in car accidents or just not been able to generate an income for themselves. And those beneficiaries were helped financially. And one of them was Patrick Mbuthu, ex-teammate of mine from the class of 2000, Kaiser Chiefs legend. He's been suffering with vision impairment. And, you know, a lot of us are not delinquents. You know, we're not all suffering from financial issues. A lot of it is simply just psychological. Mm. The camaraderie of being there and giving support of that nature is equally important. And that's what we do.
And finally, Mathew, as I wrap up with you, perhaps just for our viewers at home, just to speak about the importance of everyone doing their little bit to assist, even if it's not the Booth Foundation, but any other foundation, and just making a difference in the lives of those that have come, and I say before us, because yes, I'm a sport broadcaster, but there were those that came before me as well.
Yeah, no, absolutely. You know, I think football is so popular, it often reflects society, and in our society, everybody knows there's many gaps, and the gaps are widening. And you get fantastic NGOs who are filling those gaps. And likewise, in the sports fraternity, particularly football, there are those gaps. And we've got to try to fill them and do it in a healthy manner and hold hands with any partners that want to take us along this journey as well.
Oh, Mathew, thank you so much for joining us this morning. And thank you for the work that you're doing to help the former footballers. You know, you say we watch football because, yes, I did watch you. But we watch footballers play football, and then when it ends for them, we just do not uplift them further than what they did on the field of play. So thank you for the work that you're doing.
Only a pleasure. Thanks for the opportunity.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mathew Booth joining us this morning, speaking about the Booth Foundation and the work that they've been doing and improving the lives of former footballers, and also making a change in the communities in which they operate, and also focusing on that school football as well as youth development. And that's the note in which we wrap up your sport news for today right here on Morning Live. We do it again tomorrow on Heritage Day as we celebrate our heritage as South Africa.